We're tackling taboo topics that men don't usually want to open up about. We're talking gynecology. That's G-U-Y, not G-Y-N. Gynecology. So it's health and happenings below the belt.
Ooh, here we go. Here we go. You know, the issue with guys and our gynecology is we don't talk about it, right? Women do a really good job at normalizing that conversation and making everything okay. But guys, we don't have a place to go. We like the locker room talk.
We'll get into that.
We don't like to be vulnerable. We want to give the rah-rah speech. But sometimes, Doc, below the belt, you get up and go. Has got up and went. We need to go talk about
it. That's why I do have my urologist on speed dial.
Oh, yeah.
Not everybody does. That's why we're doing this show.
Good idea.
You know, I have my urologist colleague. I can call him anytime, any night, and he goes, oh, no, not you again. Now what's up with the plumbing? But we've got it all today, the potpourri of plumbing problems that men commonly see. So let's start off with a news flash that needs to get people talking. We're talking about you men and your significant other. Did you know we're in a global sperm slump? That's what I said. Watch this. While our pandemic-weary world is hoping 2021 is the year of a global health reset, new sound-the-alarm headlines are sobering. Add falling sperm counts to the list of threats to human survival. While it may sound doomsday, there's data behind it. Sperm counts in Western countries have taken a nosedive by more than 50% since the 70s. In a meta-analysis of 40,000 men, a fertility scientist revealed sperm count dropped a whopping 59% between 1973 and 2011. And at the current rate, half of men in Europe, Australia, New Zealand, and yes, North America will have no sperm by 2045. Yep, you heard right. And clearly, that doesn't sit well. But we're not done. At the same time sperm count is down, men's problems conceiving are rising. Erectile dysfunction is also trending up, while testosterone levels are toppling. As disturbing as this is, infertility and men's sexual health is already so stigmatized. So how do we get men talking about it and better tending to their tackle? We want to bring in an average American Joe, and this is comedian Joe Devito. He fits the bill. He gives us the everyman perspective on men's sexual health, and of course, he adds a little humor to it, which makes it that much better. Joe, welcome, and thanks so much for being here. How's it going?
Thank you. Thanks for having me as an expert on low sperm count. I appreciate it.
You know what? I should have said, how's it going? I should have said, how they hanging?
Yeah. Well, according to that video, not too great. It looks like there's another crisis south of the border. This is serious.
Well, so we are talking gynecology today. And, you know, what are men taught about penis and penile health, Joe?
We don't get a lot. We don't talk about it. And let's face it, if men were honest about their penis status, you'd never see a guy in a red convertible.